What have I been saying? This is, without a doubt, the best fall anime of 2019, at least for myself, and it's nice to see that I started out with such enthusiasm in the early stages of this anime when not a lot of people were watching it, or at least discussing it that I could see, and with each week, with as crazy as it's becoming, I'm seeing more and more people discuss it, and it brings a smile to my face as I had a lunatic giggle watching how messed up this episode was. And I'm like, did you just go to the back corners of my mind, take an anime scene, and then actually deliver it with high-quality production for the world to see? No wonder you had a content warning at the beginning of the episode, because this episode will probably mess a lot of people up, or just shock really disturbed people like myself, being like, yeah, that's what I would write if I was trying to make someone actually feel uncomfortable. This episode is incredible, and I'd go as far to say, even though we're only halfway through this anime, episode of the season contender across the board of all the anime of the fall 2019 season. That's how good it was, but it doesn't mean this is the best Babylon could be. There could easily be episodes that will make episode 7 look just okay. I don't know where this story wants to go. I wouldn't expect it would have went here even two episodes ago. But I is the best villain, without a doubt. I might even go as far to say this year. That's how much I'm liking her character and how disturbed she is. You have the whole angle of father kind of going to the world saying, hey, I'm going to kill myself to give my son my heart, but that's actually illegal. It's this whole political mastermind move to get people on board and shut down every other opposing idea. And you think, well, that's pretty damn awesome with the first half of the episode. And then they go completely wild, killing director, Zen's best friend, you got Sekiro, like, they just went all in, and I am giddy. I am, holy shit, I'm sure it messed up a lot of people. I'm just so excited to see such disturbing content actually excel, because it needed to be disturbing for the story they're telling. This is a story revolving around evil basically legalizing things that, based on how they're kind of directing it towards the public, it actually makes a whole lot of sense. The idea of, hey, if this was legal, someone could choose, do I want to die for another person in terms of an organ transplant? It's said that if you kill yourself, you can't just directly donate your organs. It's like a whole legal loophole, but should you legalize it? It's just like this mastermind level planning here, and then it all leads up to our girl getting cut up on a live broadcast. This is some slasher horror villain in the best case scenario. I honestly can't even compare this to any anime that I've seen that wasn't trying to be edgy. Like, there's plenty of anime that I've seen where characters have gotten their body parts cut up. However, for a political thriller, one that's not trying to just throw gore in your face for the sake of being gory, because that makes the viewer grow numb extremely fast. However, this is a story that, with its careful directing of cutting back and forth between Zen's family cutting a hot dog or just making their food as a body part was being ripped or sliced apart, yeah, his family's screwed. There's gonna be no happy endings in this series. And just the build-up to that was masterclass. But we do gotta talk about the whole live stream before the bad live stream. I really liked what he did. Isuki is just mastermind-level politician. The twist of the mother being I didn't see it coming, but it makes total sense, and it's even more messed up of how bad this boy is being dragged along with mastermind politics and a serial killer. Like, what the hell is going on? But the whole idea that he was going to kill himself because his son has a fragile heart and he was going to die soon, but unfortunately, should he kill himself, his heart wouldn't be able to be donated. But if he broadcasts it to the world, I'm sure there's going to be someone who will be able to donate for them, or will support his cause. And then it starts becoming this whole web of, he was never going to kill himself, but it is this like mastermind level plan of making him look like a caring father who's going to give up his life for his son. He was going to legalize suicide for the entire reason of that. But of course, why would you want to rip a father away from a dying son? Let someone else do it for them so they could have a family. Maybe it'll be someone who's alone in the world, doesn't have any real reason to live. Now that it's going to be legalized, they can say, well, my life doesn't have meaning, but clearly this loving father, he does have meaning. Why can't I kill myself, give my heart for them, right? It's like, I love these questions because you gotta remove what we know about this character. Look at it as if this is a politician who either you voted for or you didn't, and they're speaking to your heart. It does make sense in a lot of ways of like, why couldn't someone say, hey, even though life will always get better at some point, even if you have to push through, if there was a dying boy, maybe there would come a point in anyone's life saying, well, there's nothing in my life right now, I'm suffering. Why can't this little boy be saved, right? This whole organ transplant business, right? It's your life. You own it. Why couldn't you do this? And it's like those morally ambiguous questions that you don't know. There isn't a clear-cut answer. There's both pros and cons to doing things like legalizing suicide, especially legalizing it so someone could end their own life for the benefit of another, but it is something to think about. And then when you kind of tie it into the whole concept of a politician who is just manipulating the masses, especially manipulating his own son, apparently. I still don't know if it's actually his son or if maybe he was adopted or something. They're gonna pull that angle, but still, it's like some of the craziest things. You literally are manipulating into like the best possible degree. There's a reason Zen and the rest are getting progressively more pissed off because they see through the bullshit, but there's no reason the masses should. That was some of the best directing until the second half of the episode, where I was like, this episode alone is 10 out of 10 already. They didn't need to go wild, they didn't need to go brutal. I was totally content with what we were seeing with just the finishing up of the politicians' debate. It was insane. It was like, this man is about to win. He has manipulated not only his family, but the people in general. There's no way his laws aren't going to come to pass and people won't support his vision. And even if, like, you kidnap him, what's that going to solve at this point? And the lead up of realizing who the mother was and just this whole squadron, and you're losing communication by communication by communication. And you know it's not going to end well, but I still thought they could be okay, because yeah, I was probably in the building somewhere, but I didn't expect the mother to be here. And once you realize it is, all hope's gone. There's no way that you can survive that. And I thought the twist they pulled with, it's not really a twist, but it's something that it hasn't been explained in depth, I don't think ever in the show as of yet, unless I'm forgetting, because there was the whole debate with the whole, you know, uncle saying like how it kind of felt like sex and things like that, but actually have Zen's best friend explain it in such detail, and how he had to literally shoot his own leg so the pleasure wouldn't overtake him and he would kill himself. Like, it's absolutely mind-boggling that just whispering in your ear, it almost feels like you want the pleasure to continue, but you also want to reach that climax, and the climax is you dying. And the fact that everyone who kills themselves after being whispered in the ear by this girl has a smile on their face as they die, it's absolutely ridiculous, mind-shattering. How can someone have such an effect on the mind, and how was the director doing so well for so long when he was talking to her? Was she controlling herself and not making it look like she was ice? Was she kind of hiding her kind of like sexual appeal? And then once she did reveal, is that why it happened? Like, it's like, does it work on both men and females equally? Like, do you have to have some sexual preference towards women for it to work? Like, there's so much we don't know about her sexual powers, basically. These abilities aren't, like, highlighted on, like, fan service or sexually kind of provocative scenes, but rather just the seductive areas of, like, lips or eyes and how they make it so alluring, and just you understand how these characters got roped in. It almost feels like a magical presence. It's insane to watch that play out and to see the progressively mind-shattering of our main character Zen. This man, you gotta give props to his voice actor. 10 minutes, give or take, he got progressively more and more shattered. You were hearing a man break more and more, watching your best friend shoot himself in the head, and then just finding more and more bodies, seeing their wills getting progressively mad. The police obviously saying, you know, you've just experienced something so horrible, but they did kill themselves. It was a mass suicide. You have to stop acting like a lunatic because they're not in on what the whole investigation is. So of course he's just gonna seem like a deranged man who is just so disappointed and depressed on what his fellow men and friends did. But when that live broadcast starts, that's where his voice actor, I don't know how the hell he got into that role. I don't know how he got so involved that he felt like he was actually watching a loved one get tortured and brutally killed, and he couldn't look away. As a woman so delusional, who is portraying herself as a hero and then starts discussing the concept of evil and how she owns up to being evil and how they're not all that different, and how he'll eventually understand as she just slices piece after piece as we see salami or just Zen's lunch get made, and you know the family is gonna be next, and you know there probably is gonna be no happy endings for any of these characters, because even if Zen catches her, what's gonna happen? If he loses his wife, if he loses his son, if he even keeps both of them, he's lost so much. How can his mind heal after having everything ripped away from you? The careful level of directing, of focusing in on pure evil, her face and how she would light up as she would slice someone with an axe, to then how we would cut back to either just not even focusing in on the screen, but just the shaking of a man so broken and disturbed, to then the happy aura of a family cooking dinner and a lunch for their loved one. The back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. The voice acting quality insane, both on Ai as well, but of course Zen's just emotional shatter. But the delusional, deranged, lunatic persona of owning up to your evil deeds, to just the shattering realization that I will think about what you're saying, but please just stop. I expected a lot of these characters to die, and I even expected the new female prosecutor to die at some point. I just wasn't expecting it so early. When I was seeing her cut her up, I obviously wasn't expecting it, but from everything that we've seen so far with its themes and what it's been going for, I'm not shocked that they introduced something so brutal, and I wouldn't be surprised if this isn't the last that we've seen. And I think it is gonna get escalating higher and higher with each passing week. This show is mind-bending political thriller. Honestly, it's the best political thriller I've ever seen, I honestly think. I would have to give more thought to it. I am riding the high of this episode, but I love politics, I love thrillers, and mixing it and matching it into such a beautiful package, it actually feels like it's written by someone who understands politics and that landscape in general, understands how to write a good thriller and mix and match into one beautiful package. This series is amazing. This is a series that is getting progressively better week by week, and I don't know where the hell they're going next week, but this shit has contender of episode of the season written all over it. What the hell did everyone think? Let me know your thoughts down in the comment section below. If you did enjoy this video, be sure to drop a like and also hit that subscribe button if you have been new. So until next time, everyone, please take care. Don't be too disturbed, and have a good one.